Episode number 40. But this encounter, sir, is quite out of the ordinary conditions of a duel. It is a brawl, and the proof is that there were five of the Cardinal's guardsmen against my three musketeers and Monsieur d'Artagnan. That is true, said the king. But never mind, Tréville, come still by the back staircase. Tréville smiled. But as it was indeed something to have prevailed upon this child to rebel against his master, he saluted the king respectfully, and with this agreement, took leave of him. That evening the three musketeers were informed of the honor accorded them. As they had long been acquainted with the king, they were not much excited, but D'Artagnan, with his Gascon imagination, saw in it his future fortune, and passed the night in golden dreams. By 8 o'clock in the morning he was at the apartment of Athos. D'Artagnan found the musketeer dressed, and ready to go out. As the hour to wait upon the king was not till 12, he had made a party with Porthos and Aramis to play a game at tennis in a tennis court situated near the stables of the Luxembourg. Athos invited D'Artagnan to follow them, and although ignorant of the game, which he had never played, he accepted, not knowing what to do with his time from 9 o'clock in the morning, as it then scarcely was, till 12. The two musketeers were already there, and were playing together. Athos, who was very expert in all bodily exercises, passed with D'Artagnan to the opposite side, and challenged them, but at the first effort he made, although he played with his left hand, he found that his wound was yet too recent to allow of such exertion. D'Artagnan remained, therefore, alone. And as he declared he was too ignorant of the game to play it regularly, they only continued giving balls to one another without counting. But one of these balls, launched by Porthos' Herculean hand, passed so close to D'Artagnan's face that he thought that if, instead of passing near, it had hit him, his audience would have been probably lost, as it would have been impossible for him to present himself before the king. Now, as upon this audience, in his Gascon imagination, depended his future life, he saluted Aramis and Porthos politely, declaring that he would not resume the game until he should be prepared to play with them on more equal terms, and went, and took his place near the court, and in the gallery. Unfortunately for D'Artagnan, among the spectators was one of his eminence's guardsmen, who, still irritated by the defeat of his companions, which had happened only the day before, had promised himself to seize the first opportunity of avenging it. He believed this opportunity was now come, and addressed his neighbor. It is not astonishing that that young man should be afraid of a ball, for he's doubtless a musketeer apprentice. D'Artagnan turned round as if a serpent had stung him, and fixed his eyes intensely upon the guardsman, who had just made this insolent speech. Pardieu, resumed the latter, twisting his moustache. Look at me as long as you like, my little gentleman. I have said what I have said. And as, since that which you have said is too clear to require any explanation, replied D'Artagnan, in a low voice, I beg you to follow me.